Here I am.
Do you want to do like
hurricane?
Here I am.
Huh?
Rocked you like a hurricane.
Darn it. So we'll do the intro. But pause for a second and then do the outro. What's up, everybody, and welcome to another edition of On a Couch Talking Sports. We're here inside our On a Couch Studios, makeshift studios, I guess you could call it. As always, I'm Robbie. This is Kyle. Kyle, how are you?
Robbie, I'm doing fine. I had a big, big, huge, huge thing of ice cream, so I'm a little full, not gonna lie.
So am I.
I had to roll myself to my car after I got a Friendly's today, so. But that's okay, we're good. We're good.
Yeah, we're good to go.
Good to go.
I know it's been a while, a week or so since we made an episode, but we're back at you. Don't worry, we didn't go anywhere. And so for tonight's episode, we're going to have a little fun. We're going to be a little competitive. Because you know Kyle and I sometimes like to get kind of competitive with each other and try and best each other in various activities. Well, tonight, we are going to take it to another level.
We're going to dine in hell. Sorry, what do you think?
Nice reference there.
Thank you.
What we have done is we have taken a clip from the 2011 Bruins-Canadiens Game 7 of the Eastern Conference quarterfinals. Won by the Bruins, by the way, 4-3 in overtime.
Victory for some, tearjerker for others.
Yeah, I'm sorry, buddy. It's okay. It's okay. You made it through. Okay.
I'm good, over it.
Yeah.
I'm over it.
I would hope so. But anyway, what we have done is we have voiced over us separately announcing the game-winning goal by the Bruins. And Kyle, I think it was actually pretty fun doing. Definitely, we sort of did our own sort of personal styles to it.
A little bit. I especially with him being really well versed in the art of sports announcing versus me, who's never ever announced anything sports related in his life, they're very different announcements you'll see in the the very different clips.
this competition is definitely viewer based, because here's what you as the viewer get to do: watch the videos and you're gonna comment in the comments right down below, whether on YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, wherever you watch this video, you're going to comment which video you thought, or which announcing, I should say, you thought was best. And whoever gets the most votes will win. So, without any further ado, let's go to the tape. Face off to the right of Price, won by the Bruins as they take it down behind the net. Now it goes down to the far side corner. Both teams battling for it. It comes down back into the corner. Lucic gloves it down. Lucic over to Horton. He fires and he scores! Nathan Horton from inside the blue line, and the Bruins win the series in overtime, and it's Bedlam at TD Garden as the Bruins knock out the Canadiens.
And here we go, two guys are facing off, and the puck is flying. Players are going to get the puck. Someone's got the puck. One of the Canadians got the puck, and he's passing to another Canadian. Oh, now it's a Bruin player that's got the puck. Puck's flying, stuck in a corner. It's flying. It's flying and stuck in a corner again. Why am I keep saying that? Okay, so then he gets the puck in. Oh, he shoots, and he scores. I am so disappointed in this. Puck you, sir, he says. Puck you, sir. What a disgrace. Look at this. What's a disgrace? All the Boston fans are cheering, while the Canadian fans are just they're pretty sad.
So there you have it. You have two very different styles to choose from.
Yep.
You have Kyle and his sort of unorthodox style, but still made it work, made it fit. Oh,
thank you, appreciate it.
And you have my style, which is and then my style, which is kind of self-explanatory.
He's professional. Let's put it that way.
Semi-professional. But anyway, the choice is yours. Comment, which announcing did you like better? And on the next show, we will announce the results. So, that being said, now we're going to move on to sort of the end part of our show, our monologues. I'm going to begin, I think we're both going to keep it kind of on a hockey tangent here tonight.
Yeah, we might as well just call this like a big hockey episode. It's all about hockey.
Yeah.
It's left and right.
So mine's going to be about this. The Frozen Four, which for those of you who don't know, is the Final Four of men's college ice hockey, is coming to Boston next week, next Thursday actually. So a week from tonight are the semifinals, and Saturday, a week from Saturday, are the finals. So the four teams are as follows. The first semifinal game features a team that Kyle knows very well, the Providence College Friars, versus the Mavericks, I believe they're called, the University of Nebraska Omaha. And then in the second game, you have the North Dakota, technically they're not called the Fighting Sioux anymore, but I still call them the Fighting Sioux. The North Dakota Fighting Sioux versus Boston's own Boston University Terriers. So I just want to quickly throw out some picks, to the best of my ability. I'm going to go I'm going to slant towards one league on this. I'm going to go Providence in the first game. Because Providence just has a ton of momentum right now, and I think that they can be... I know Nebraska Omaha is a really good goaltender, but I think Providence is just a little bit stronger than they are. So I think Providence gets it done. And then, hate to say it, but I'm going to go... Even though I won't be rooting for them, I'm going to go BU in the second semifinal. I think that they have a lot of momentum right now, won the Hockey East Championship. They're used to playing at the Garden, playing there in the Bean Pie and the Hockey East Championship. I think that's enough to get them over the hump. So I'm going to say an all-Hockey East National Championship game, Providence versus BU. And my pick, drumroll please. Providence College is going to win the National Championship at TD Garden. You heard it here first. The Friars are going to get it done over BU. It's going to be awesome. And yeah, take that, BU. You thought maybe I was gonna go with you, but I'm not taking it that far. I picked you once. I'm not going to pick you again.
Only the semifinals. That's it. That's all you got, huh?
Yeah. So that's my monologue. We'll see. We'll see how true my predictions become. I could end up being wrong both times, but who knows? So Kyle, I know you got some. Right. I know you got a little college hockey-based thing as well.
Yeah, actually,
Go ahead, take it to us. Like, take it for us.
On a similar note to what Robbie was saying, he was talking about the Frozen Four. I went to, I believe it was two weekends ago. I actually went to a very similar event. It was the college hockey, the ECAC tournaments, which had four teams competing.
Four.
They had St. Lawrence, Harvard.
Harvard.
I think it was, what is it, hold on, Colgate, and was it Quinnipiac? I think it was Quinnipiac.
Yeah, I believe it was Quinnipiac.
Yeah, so I...
just tell us who won that tournament.
Oh, and I just wanted to mention really quickly, first of all, Harvard.
The Crimson!
Took the gold.
Representing Boston. All right, go
They
Crimson.
Were the team I was definitely like cheering for the most, I'd say, of all those teams. Harvard.
Really? You? No, I'm kidding.
I know. Well, especially with, the whole Darkman thing. But anyways, I was definitely rooting for Harvard all the way. Again, the local teams going, cheering for the local teams. And it was nice seeing, that last game especially. It was a really tight game for a while. The big final game it was Harvard and Colgate, I believe. But it was just a great game to watch. And Harvard really, man, they like, the last game, I didn't even see the last goal. They won 4-2. They shot a goal and I barely even saw it. I'm like, wait, what? It went by so quickly, but it was such a great game. The crowds were there. Even the Colgate fans were so intense. I had a guy
right down the row. He was just like, he had his face painted, and he was just yelling. He was so into it. His soul was in this game. It was pretty interesting, I gotta say. And, oh, for those of you guys who don't know where this took place up in Lake Placid, where the famous 1980s Olympics
Miracle
hockey game.
Miracle on Ice.
Miracle on Ice, exactly. If you ever saw the movie Miracle, and if you heard about what I talked about last year, this is the same place I went to as last year, in the episode that we aired about a year ago. I talked about this place as well. That's where they held it. So they held it again this year. Great venue. I mean, that rink has a lot of history to it, a lot of great memories. It was where the U.S. beat the Russians 3-2, I believe, right?
Correct.
Yeah, 3-2. So.
It was 3-2 or 4-3. I can't remember which.
One of them, yeah.
Yeah, something like that.
Don't know the exact score, but
if I remember, comment below.
Yeah, exactly. But it was a great event, great place to go. If you're ever looking for a vacationing place during the winter or during the summer, or pretty much anytime during the year. So it's a great, Lake Placid's a great place. They just got a lot to do. Skiing, snowboarding, they got a lot of summer activities in the lake, and yeah, you won't be disappointed, trust me.
Very nice. Yeah, I know you enjoyed Lake Placid last year. I'm glad to know you had the same experience this year.
It was awesome. It's a great place to be.
Alright. Well, thank you, Kyle, as always. So that's going to wrap up this edition of On the Couch Talking Sports. Again, comment on who you think had the better announcing, and we'll see who won next episode. Until then, for Kyle, I'm Robbie. That's a bottle of Coca-Cola.
Is it? Or is it Pepsi? See if you can guess in the comments.
I just gave it away, but that's okay. And plus it got the red cap.
No, it's not. Maybe it's Pepsi in it.
Anyway, signing off here from On the Couch Talking Sports. We'll see you next time.